I train a few cops at my gym, and I am just as relentless with them as I am with you guys out here. On a 500 meter row, you should feel like absolute death afterwards, okay? It should not be easy. And this one cop of mine who's just, I'll tell it, she's a pain in my ass, and she always complains about the sumo deadlift high pull. Well, a couple weeks ago, there was a situation where she couldn't get back up, and she had a drunk, probably 200 pound guy laying all over the floor who was being belligerent. And she had no way to get another guy there to help her out. So she called me and she just was like so ecstatic. She goes, I just want to thank you for always being that bitch, okay? And making me do this stupid move. She's like, because when this guy was on the floor, I actually straddled him. She put her arms into his armpits and she pulled him up to a standing position to where she could get him in the car. So we teach that these moves are functional in real life, okay? These are applicable in your daily life and your daily jobs. Okay, so it wasn't a beautiful sumo deadlift high pull. I mean, she didn't get the guy to standing, but she was able to get his big ass in the car without any assistance. Okay? Let's go, knock it out. Come on, right back down. Excellent. No shallow squats, guys. Come on. Pull your chest up, babe. Pull your chest up. Stay active here. All right. So sumo deadlift high pull. Can I use this real quick again? Sumo deadlift high pull. The setup only changes with the stance. So you're going to take your stance out to that nice sumo stance and your grip. Okay. So I like to grip thumbs distance. Okay. So like here, nice narrow grip. And you only want your feet wide enough to where your knees can still safely trace over your feet. You don't want the knees to cave in. Okay, so a really good example that works for me is look like a silverback gorilla, right?